howdy. That's the greetings in these parts, and when you come to College Station, Texas, you know that the Aggies are ready to gig 'em. Kyle Field will be swaying and electric for this one. What a game, and what potential drama we have in store. You've seen this script before. Top 10 team goes into a cauldron of emotion on the road and just hopes to be able to get out and tell about it. As we'll see the number 5 team in the country, the Ole Miss Rebels, taking on the 24th ranked team in the land, the Texas A&M Aggies. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack and Jesse Palmer with me. Guys, it's time to get it going. Texas A&M set to kick off to christen this game. What kind of field position can he help them with on the return? Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. So Ole Miss offense takes the field. And here's the man they rally around, and he has earned that type of respect, David.
You dang right. You earn it by doing it, and he's done it at such a high level. Everyone believes in this young man, and Palmer, there's a reason why.
You're right, David. He's been in the big moments, and he's won the big games. This guy delivers when the game is on the line.
And the Rebels want to pick up the tempo. He'll do it himself. Got the first down and more. And the ball's on the ground. Once that ball was loose, offense didn't have a chance. Defenders everywhere. It's a turnover.
I love those smashes where you can hear it up here, Reese. Goodness gracious, you can hear the contact. Such a big lick. The offensive guy doesn't hold onto the football. Huge momentum swing, big turnover forced by the defense.
Looking for a productive play on first down. They're going to test the right side with this one. One step wrap, two step squeeze. This junior knows how to get him on the ground.
All right, well, the offense here, they're trying to get this run game established. They obviously don't break off a long run there, but they're just trying to find their footing at this point.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. The gift to the back. And he's able to find a little bit of running room before they get him down.
Listen, I know that's not a huge game, but those run plays add up. They make you tackle the back every single play. Physically, you have to get some guy on the ground. It takes its toll throughout a fourth quarter game.
They really need to convert this 3rd and 1 to capitalize on that great field position. Breaks the tackle. They were all over him, nowhere to go as that 3rd down play turned into a disaster.
And that's a great job by the defense, understanding exactly the situation, understanding to stay home, play sound. No matter who gets the football, we're going to run to the football hard. We're going to cage the football, be disciplined. Nice job by the defense.
It's good. And with that, they break the seal on the scoring. It's 3-0.
Winning the turnover battle is so important, and you got to make these turnovers convert into points. They get the fumble recovery. Yeah, they didn't get a touchdown, but they're still able to get a field goal and put 3 points up on the board.
After that last field goal drive, they're set to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Ole Miss ready to send the offense onto the field. They coughed it up on that last drive, but the defense really bailed them out, holding him to a field goal, Jesse.
Yeah, and I think the offense kind of got away from their identity a little bit on that last drive, David. They got to kind of get back to doing what they do.
Yeah, and hold on to the football. I mean, defense just did their job, stopped them, held them to a field goal, limited the damage. Now it's time for the offense to get the momentum going again.
The Rebels moving quickly to the line. They go right back to him. Stacked up after gaining a couple to the 23. Better find the earplugs. Here comes the noise. Backing this defense on third down. Back to pass. It's Dart. Got his man quickly. At the 35, he's got room. And it is well blocked as they pick up enough for a first down. We asked earlier this week, who's your favorite receiver? And of course, he said the open one. But we know who he really wants to go to on third down.
The best one. I mean, I think the open one, obviously the politically correct answer. But you want to find the guy that you got that great chemistry with. You know exactly where he's going to be. You got that bond and that trust.
Leaves it with the running back. Gets it past the first down marker and still running. And he's brought down after a nice game.
Well, if at first you don't succeed, try again, right? It's been really hard for this offense in this game to run the football, but they finally break off a big run there. That could be the play they need to really generate momentum and get this run game going.
They'll throw it on first down. Catch in the middle. It's Harris. They make the stop, but the sweet throwing catch is plenty to give them a first down. Live by the blitz. Get hit with a chunk play on the blitz, too, especially if you're man up on that dude.
And you know what? You lose some battles, especially to receivers like this who are so elite. You're going to lose some of those, but I'm still going to be aggressive. I'm still going to play man. I'm still going to have to bring some blitzes. So I look for this defense to stay aggressive, but maybe give that guy a smidge more attention.
He's looking to throw it. Caught behind the line. It's Harris. And they pick up just a few on that completion.
Ooh, and that was close for the offense. They try to go wide receiver screen. They're counting on that receiver beating that defender. Wasn't able to make a miss that time, but if I'm on offense, I'm going back to that play later.
Offense in the hurry up. He'll keep it himself. Got enough for the first down and wants more. He's brought down, but there's a flag on the play. Let's see if it stands. Well, that was an easy one for the officials. You can't grab a face mask like that, and it costs the defense a first down. Here's the handoff. That one did not go well. Tackled in the backfield for a loss of six. It's amazing how play by a defensive end in the backfield can really swing the momentum not only of a series but of a game sometimes.
All you're trying to do is create negative plays, to get them behind the sticks a little bit, to get those sacks, to get those tackles for losses. You see so much stunting in college football up front with the defensive line because you know once you get one of those plays, you've got the offense right where you are.
That pass is incomplete, and they're probably fortunate that it wasn't knocked free for a fumble. Third down, and this crowd will blow out a vocal cord to help this defense. Looking for a man. It's Dart. Just threw that one away to avoid disaster.
Really nice third down sub defense there that time. It's third and long. They're expecting pass. And they're mixing up their looks. They're trying to change the picture pre-snap to post-snap to confuse the quarterback. Now forcing the incompletion, setting up fourth.
Now on fourth down, here comes the field goal team. The holder will spot it about 35 yards out. Right down the boulevard. It's good. And the three ball gives us a tie. And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. On the run from inside his own five. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. They'll go to the ground. Got enough for the first down. And he surges up to the 36-yard line, and they'll move the chains.
Really good-looking run there. This guy reminds me a little bit of an old Texas A&M Aggie great, Leland McElroy. He was so dangerous in space, was so difficult to bring down to the ground. All 11 guys on defense had to rally to the football. This guy has a little bit of that, too. If they can find more creative ways to get this guy out in the open field, watch out, because he's a home run waiting to happen.
We'll give him a couple on that one. Second and 8 coming up.
Well, man, there's some big hitting going on in the trenches right now. This defense, they take a lot of pride in stopping the run. Let's keep our eye on them throughout the course of the game and see if they can contain this running attack.
After picking up a couple at 2nd and 8. Wide receiver shows motion. Touch pass on the run. Got enough for the first, and he's still going. They'll get him down, but not before he crosses the 50. He's down to the 49. It's been punch, counterpunch throughout the early part of this game as we take a look at the first quarter stats. We've got a good one going here and looking forward to keep those vibes rolling here in the second. And the Aggies will line it up on 1st and 10. Wide receiver now comes in motion. They'll leave it with him. Got room at the 35. And he found all kinds of room and got it down to the 28.
Nice job getting outside, right? Those running backs, they get on those tracks, they run outside. Now they're in the open field. It's so tough. Those safeties are flying down, try to get an angle, but you could tell the speed sets them up, makes the big play out to the left.
Texas A&M going quickly. They'll throw it on 1st down. Snagged in the middle, it's Muhammad. Excellent job working through the air there, finding a hole in that defense and picking up a 1st down.
This offense is just so dynamic because they've got playmakers at all the skill positions, right? We just saw a big play in the running game. Now we see one in the passing game. There's not one dude that you can key on here if you're on defense to try and slow them down.
They'll give it to the back. He rolls all the way down to the 5-yard line before they finally get him stopped.
1st down, you know you always want to establish the run again. How about this offense? Nothing fancy. Run the football, be physical, get a big game.
The Aggies trying to get a touchdown on 1st and goal. Wide receiver coming across in motion. Turning to the running game on 1st and goal. And maybe he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that.
Great job at contained by this defense. And in order to do that, the end man on the line of scrimmage defensively has got to be able to set the point and force the football back into traffic. And that's exactly what happened.
After getting nothing, it's 2nd and goal from the 6. The run up the middle, trying to find his way to the goal line. They get him on the ground at the 3-yard line, but this defense is taking some punches.
And with the stuff there, Jesse, on 2nd down, this little 3rd to mid-range, you got 2 downs. What are you thinking here?
Maybe getting your quarterback out on the perimeter and giving him a run pass option. See if you can get the defense in a bind.
Wide out in motion. Little touch pass to the receiver. That just never had a chance as they controlled the middle of the field and stopped him in the backfield on 3rd down.
And that's a gut punch, especially if you're the offensive coordinator, because that was sort of a foreign look, the pre-snap motion, a timing play, trying to get the receiver the football quickly. You're expecting to outflank the defense, but give the defense a ton of credit. They made the bigger play, and now they've set you up in a 4th down.
It's good. He hit that one right down the middle. And with that field goal, they now have the lead. So after the made field goal, they'll kick it away and rely on their defense. And he takes this from inside the five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The Ole Miss offense ready to go back to work. David, they couldn't pay off that last drive with a touchdown.
Now they moved the ball down the field and executed like they wanted to until they stalled out and had to settle for a field goal.
I think if you want to take the next step too here and score a touchdown, you got to start finding more creative ways to get your best players the ball. Let's see if they can do that here.
And the Rebels come to the line in the hurry up. From the gun. Give on the inside. Tackle is made after the first down.
Well, it's not a home run, but it's just enough by the running back to move the chains.
They'll snap this one from the 30 on first and 10. Out of the gun, the running back has it. Couldn't find a lane, a pickup of one to the 31.
Yeah, and the running back didn't get much here, but, you know, you clearly want to always establish the tempo, run the football, be consistent, make that defense physically meet the challenge.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and 9. Motion trying to get the defense to show its hand. Unloads quickly. Boy, that was a precision play all the way around. Throw, catch, tackle, bang, bang, bang.
Well, we knew coming into this game, this offense was going to try and get this receiver involved and get him involved early. So here they are just finding an easy completion. It's not a touchdown, but they just want to get this guy lathered up and get him into a run.
To the ground to try to pick up the first. Fights his way for a couple, but stopped short of the marker. It's fourth and 1. We've reached the 2-minute warning, and we have ourselves a ball game, and they have a chance to take the lead here before the half. The Rebels will call on their punt team. First time we've seen their punt team this afternoon. They're able to put a stop to that return right at the 30-yard line. Texas A&M has it back, and we say howdy to the Aggie offense again. They had to settle for the chip shot field goal last time, Jesse. They'd love for this one to pay off bigger.
Yeah, it just comes down to execution, too. Did a nice job out in the field, stalled a little bit once they got down to the goal line, so they just need to be a little bit more crisp here, Dave.
Yeah, and listen, I think the first part was the most important part. You got to put the drive together first to get down there. Now, when we get down there, focus on execution and getting 6 points.
Looking to throw, it's Wegman. Throws to the wideout. Got his man downfield. Got a lot of running room. And after gobbling up some serious yardage and showing off those wheels, he's finally out of bounds.
And what a huge play for the offense. Hitting that throw not only is big for their confidence, but it also flips the field.
It's first and goal as Texas A&M comes to the line. He wants to throw. He's got it. And he was dying to push his way in there, but he's knocked down at the 3.
Nice quick throw there. And it's so important for quarterbacks to be able to find a rhythm and to be comfortable and confident. You want to just get the ball out quickly, make it an accurate and easy throw. And you can tell that these two guys, they rep that play in practice all the time, and it's now showing up here on game.
Pushes ahead. And this defense does it again. Back-to-back plays for nothing. It'll be third down.
And so how physical are you willing to be offensively at this point on third down coming up? Do you want to keep trying to run the football? I mean, you're right there at the goal line. How do you want to do it, though? You want to spread him out, maybe go zone read in the middle, give your quarterback the option to keep it? Or do you want to bring the big fellas in, go jumbo formation, and just try to impose your will?
The defense stiffened on the last play. Now it's third and goal again from the two. And this one will be stopped for no gain. We've got a timeout here late in the first half, and they'll try to get more points on the board before the break.
Second quarter might not be gamble time, but inside the three, Palmer, I've got the green light. I'm going for this.
I am too, and you're essentially running a two-point play here, right? You've got a play you practice all week long. That's the play you dial up right here.
It's good. He could have hit a string right in the middle of the uprights there. So they put the field goal on the board and about to kick it away, and hoping that'll be the final points of this first half. On the move from inside is five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Ole Miss ready to send the offense onto the field. So late in the half, this is really an opportunity, David, maybe to swing the momentum in their favor.
Dang right. There's no time to be conservative. We're a little bit down. Listen, I just think this is a point with the offense that they can prove. Like, we're here, we're going to create something now that we can build on in the second half.
Coach said all week he wanted to be aggressive. This is a great opportunity to show that right now. At the end of the first half, try and generate some momentum, score some points before going into halftime.
After the incompletion, they go back up top. Caught near the sideline, it's Harris. And he goes out of bounds after a nice pickup on that one.
And a great play design here in this type of situation, obviously trailing, you're trying to put something up on the scoreboard and just using the sideline, using the boundary, getting the ball out of bounds and stopping the clock.
Here comes this home crowd as the defense tries to get off the field on third down. The throw to the outside is complete. There's a timeout called as this offense tries to find a way to draw a little closer.
Well, we know this guy is special, and because of that, his quarterback is looking to him on critical down and distances. There on that third down, there was no question. It wouldn't have mattered if he was single covered, double covered, man, zone. That's where he was going with it, and the big-time playmaker outside picks up the first.
Finally, this offense starting to show a little juice. They've got a first and 10. Back to throw. It's Dart. They're bringing heat. And he got smacked just as he released the pass. It's incomplete.
This pass rush is serious, man. When you watch them on film, they do a nice job in the back end, taking away all the throws downfield. He's trying to get to his check down, but that pressure, it gets to him, and the hit forced the incomplete.
Four wide out set, two on either side on second and 10. He's looking to throw. He's got it. The offense calls a timeout to stop the clock. Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. On third and long, he has to throw for it. Couldn't find a man and just had to throw it away to avoid a negative play.
Well, on third and short and field goal range, they dial up the pass play. Quarterback was trying to get through his progressions. There was just simply nobody open. Couldn't make an accurate enough throw. Ball falls incomplete. Now setting up a big decision here on fourth down.
And on fourth down, they'll try to put three on the board. And this one splits the uprights.
Well, that kid just showed off his hammer for a leg, 50-plus, and he did it with ease.
So they get the late field goal right before the half and not much time after this kickoff for an answer. Here he comes from inside his own five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Under a minute to play here in the first half, and the offense will take a knee, and that is how we'll wrap up the first half. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Gentlemen, what else is new? A really raucous environment there in College Station. And I get it. A lot of coaches will say the difference between winning and losing comes down to stopping big plays and getting big plays. But if you ask me, it's more about how good you are on third down and how efficient you are in keeping drives alive. Those two stats can help you break the will of even the best defenses and help you come out on top. With that said, let's send it back to the guys at the home of the 12th man.
And the Rebels will kick it off to start the second half. He'll start the return inside his five. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. Texas A&M has it back in the offense, ready to go to work. And in a low-scoring game like this one, David, every possession is magnified.
And I think more than anything, it just gets frustrating. And you got to put that behind you. You got to see what this defense has been doing to be so successful. Palmer, now use it against them.
Yeah, David, I think for a play caller, this is tough, right? It's like you have to have the perfect play on just to get a first down. In these types of games, I think you're just trying to get guys out in space. See if a dude can break a tackle. Maybe that generates an explosive play, and it breaks this trend.
And they'll get it to the 39-yard line, and they'll move the chains.
One of the things I love about this offense, Reese, is they have tons of speed. They like to try to get the ball going east-west. That time, they generate a huge play going to the right side.
And the defense either not fast enough to fit or got knocked out of the fit.
Yeah, they got to do a better job containing that as this game goes on. They got to funnel the football back to the middle of the field.
Leaves it with the back. Good pickup on that play. It'll bring up second and four.
I know the passing game sells and the passing game is exciting, but it's not exciting to get 5 or 6 yards of pop on the ground, but it will be very successful.
6 yard pickup on first down leaves him with second and four. Fast motion from the offense. They've softened them up with a run. Now to throw it. Grabbed over the middle. It's Thomas. And this defense was flailing as he weaved his way and got down to the 26.
Well, really nice catch there. And I'll tell you, ever since Texas A&M made the move to the SEC, their path to the national championship got way harder. If they're going to win today, they've got to come up with big plays in the passing game. This guy gives them that opportunity. He gives them a chance not just to compete for conference titles, but for national championships, too.
And the Aggies will hustle to the line. And I don't think they got it snapped before the play clock ran out. Offense took a little bit too much time at the line there. Texas A&M ready to go with another first down. To the air. It's Wegman. He makes the connection. Hard-hitting tackle. Using him out of the slot, he has just been unstoppable.
And I love putting dynamic athletes in the slot that I can move around, that I can put in motion, that I can make him go in or out. I can put him off the ball so you can't get hands on him. And they've really featured this guy today.
Running the red zone, it's Moss. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry.
You can't let the same guy beat you over and over and over again. You got to make adjustments. Sometimes you got to bring more guys in the box, more guys to the football, and make sure he's not the one who beat you.
Already in chip shot field goal range at the 21, but this third and short, they're still thinking touchdown. It's complete on the right side. And he motors into the end zone. Touchdown, Texas A&M. If you're able to move the ball in a drive like that, the most overrated stat in football would be field position.
Agreed, and I think confidence is big right now after that last drive. To be able to flip the field like that, not just do it, but go down and score a touchdown. Running and throwing, for this offense now moving forward in this game, that last drive is going to pay big dividends.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, they're now up by a touchdown and a field goal at 10. They're lining up to boot it away. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Ole Miss offense ready to go back to work. The deficit here is just 10 points, David, so a chance to answer here.
Plenty of time left in this football game. No need to panic. This offense just has to put a couple drives together. And listen, the defense will get this back and get some stops, Palmer, and get you the football back.
And I think here too, David, you have an opportunity to keep the pressure on the opponent. Yeah, they just went down and scored, but you score here, and this game's still tight. You keep their feet to the fire, so an opportunity here to keep applying that pressure.
Now the play fake. Fires to the wideout. A strike downfield. And a pickup of better than 30 yards on that completion before the defense brings him down.
Nice play design on that one. You make it easy for your quarterback, too, because it's easy to see what's happening right in front of you. Over the middle of the field, you can see where defenders are dropping. You can see where the soft spots are in zone coverage. And just a really nice job by the QB locating his guy and making an accurate throw.
Wants to throw on first down off the play fake. Going for it all. Makes the catch down the right side. And chunk plays are the name of the game, and they get one here before the defense finally makes the stop. The Rebels racing to the line in the hurry up. From the gun, the ground game. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, the linebacker showing you read and react. He knew exactly where that running play was going, and he beat the football to the line of scrimmage and forced the TFL.
This crowd knows they have to bring it in big moments, and one of those has arrived. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him. They make the stop, but they give up 5 yards on the run. It's down to the 11.
It's going to be important this offensive line is able to get a little bit of push. Just got to give this guy an inch, a little crease, and he can make yards for it.
Boy, they'd love to pick up this conversion and go to work with a first and goal. On the move, it's Dart. Snags it over the middle. And he couldn't quite get to the marker, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. They'd hope to be able to pick up enough after the catch, but a good stop leaves them with a fourth and short.
Really good job by the defense being physical, understanding the situation of the game. The ball's going to come out quick. You know that. Go make the tackle. Force the fourth down.
So this field goal unit has been getting the job done. They've already made a couple here today. No, no good. Guys, that field goal could loom large, missing an opportunity to get within a touchdown. We're still sitting on a 10-point game. Texas A&M has it back, and we say howdy to the Aggie offense again. That last touchdown drive was surgical through the air, Jesse.
It sure was, and that's why this offense is so dangerous, David, because they can score in a hurry because of how efficient they are throwing the football.
And welcome to modern college football. That's what it is. Spread you out, find my playmakers, make quick decisions, and really put defenses in a difficult situation.
This offense set up with a second and short. The give. He maybe gets a yard. They'll mark him at the 29. Texas A&M has the lead at the end of the quarter. They've built a cushion. They've got a nice lead. Now the task is finish the deal as you take a look at the third quarter stats. Not only is the scoreboard on their side, but so too is time as we open the fourth. On third and short, the run and looking for the first down. Hey, get him on the ground after he gets enough to move the sticks.
Man, this offense would really like to lean on this guy in the fourth quarter, right? They've got the lead, and you just saw his ability there, breaking a tackle. He looks like he's getting stronger as the game goes on. I'd expect him to get a few more carries here before this game's over.
Quarterback on the keeper. And a nice run there before the defense finally makes the stop.
In situations like this, offensively, when you got the lead in the fourth quarter, when you got to run the ball, you go back to the runs that you have the most confidence in, that you can execute in your sleep, and they do it right there, ripping off 7 yards.
Now on second and short. On the run, it's Moss. They get him on the ground, but that'll be enough to give Texas A&M a first down.
You got to have short area quickness. That running back there doing what it takes to make sure he got that first down.
This Texas A&M offense is wasting no time. Might as well run him until they stop him. He's got it again. They'll stop him at the 41, but he's got 10 yards and they'll move the chains.
Everything going the offense's way. They're trying to ice this game late. They got a really nice lead, so you just want to run the ball, high percentage throws, and keep the chains moving, and they're doing that. This has been a beautiful drive to watch. Offense continues to stay in a nice rhythm here late.
Quickly to the tight end. And he might be known for run fits, but that was a sure and heavy tackle on the tight end.
This offense is not letting up, guys. They've got a lead here late, and they are still taking shots. They're still looking for explosive plays. This defense just has not had an answer here all game long.
This drive has already drained more than 3 minutes off the clock, and now they've got it on second down. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry.
It's going to be tough sledding for the offense here. They're trying to ice this game by running the football and bleeding the clock. They've got a pretty good lead here late in the game, but the defense knows the run's coming, right? So they're going to be loading the line of scrimmage, getting stops like what they just did. Be interesting to see what the offense does on this next one.
On third down, he drops to throw. Catch in the middle, it's Thomas. And they stop him just short of the stick. It'll bring up a decision on fourth down. Fourth down and 3, and they'll try to pick it up. They'll try it on the ground. He didn't make it. They'll have to give up the football, and hope is still alive. A first down for the offense.
Well, you're up by 2 possessions in the fourth quarter. They're hoping with that conversion they ice the game. They don't get it. It feels like they're going to win, but we've seen crazy things happen in college football, and they've left the door open here late. Let's see what happens.
And the Rebels in the hurry up. Back to pass. It's Dart. Unloads to the wideout. finds a man in the middle. And he's brought down after a nice game.
This defense better not blink. I know they've got a lead here in the fourth quarter, but just look at who they're going against. This quarterback is one of the best in the nation. They cannot rest on their laurels. Someone's going to have to make a play.
It's first and 10. They've moved it to the 41. He's going to pass. Dances away again. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up.
This is an offense that has skill, and they've got speed. And because of that, this defense, they can't lull themselves to sleep. They've got a big lead here late, but they've now given up back-to-back big plays. They got to put the clamps down.
The Rebels will snap it on first and 10. Trying to cap this drive with a pass. Dumps it off in the flats. And he is going to be forced out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage. Tremendous defense there. Still some work to do after that last completion at second down. He wants to throw it again. He makes a grab. He stopped just short of the goal line at the one. An explosive play has him set up.
I'll tell you what, that's great execution between the QB and receiver. They look like they could execute that throw in their sleep. Quarterback took his steps, threw it on time. Great route by the receiver. Nice job securing the catch.
It's a first down. They'll stop the clock to reset the chains. Offense up tempo. On the run, it's Dart. Going for six. This is caught for the late touchdown, so let's not put this one to bed just yet.
Yeah, and that's step one. Great job by this offense getting in the end zone. Now you got to go get the stop. You got to get the football back. You got to find a way to do something to create a turnover, get an onside to get the football back, to get back in this football game.
PAT unit on the field. And with the extra point, every little bit counts as they get closer. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And it was capped off by a one-yard touchdown pass. The kickoff team on the field as they'll send this one away. On the run from inside his own five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. Texas A&M has it back in the offense, ready to go to work. Guys, you want to be productive here and not go into a shell, but you've got to take care of the ball.
Yeah, and I think you say productive, Reese. Productive at this point in the game is running the clock and getting first down. So, Jesse, I can expect this defense to be aggressive, way up near the line of scrimmage, bringing a bunch of bodies, trying to stop the run.
And that's why it puts a lot of pressure on an offense, David, because you know if you do try to throw the football, it's probably man coverage, you're probably getting blitzed, it's going to be into a small window. It is not easy to execute in this situation of the game.
Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. Now on first and 10 from the 27. They'll try to keep this clock moving on the ground. Didn't get much done on that run. He'll fight his way out and maybe pick up a yard.
As an offense, you've got the lead. You've had success running the football. You hope that this play is just a blip because you know you're going to have to lean on your bell cow running back to ice this game and close it.
And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage.
You got to fight fire with fire. You got to fight speed with speed. There's a receiver with the ball out in the open field trying to get the corner, but a cornerback with the same type of speed and athleticism able to make the tackle. Nice job.
Don't want to risk anything here. The quarterback takes a knee.
And that's the best formation you practice every single week because you know the ball game is over. We just did enough to get it done. Just watch it tick down to zero and enjoy the dub.
Texas A&M will have to boot it away. He only needs a sliver of daylight. And you make the stop, and that is exactly what you want out of your punt cover unit.